The last round of rain is helping drought-stricken waterways around the Central Coast. The San Lorenzo River in Santa Cruz County was at about 3 feet before the storm, last storm, got up to about 5.5 feet at the height of that system. Loch Lomond's levels are up, but still far from enough to meet the needs of the community.
We are hearing that we're supposed to get a lot of rain, and we are crossing our fingers and hoping we will. Is it going to make a big impact on the drought? No, it's probably not. But any little bit of water right now helps.
Meantime, Santa Cruz City leaders declared a Stage 3 water emergency on Tuesday night this week, meaning mandatory water rationing is going to go into effect May 1st. They're asking water customers to cut water use by 20% to 25%. You wouldn't pay higher rates unless the water you use goes over the actual levels. First-time offenders in that case could face a $25 fine.
And today, state lawmakers passed a nearly $700 million plan that would provide immediate relief to communities trying to deal with the drought. And that means emergency money for those at risk of running out of drinking water. Action News reporter Mae Chow joins us live with more on when the money will be available.
Aaron, the bill is headed to Governor Brown, who himself pitched the plan last week, and the emergency measures will go into effect once he signs the legislation.
As one of 17 communities in California at risk of running out of water, the village of Lompico in the Santa Cruz Mountains is on the receiving end of state emergency money.
I mean, I knew that our area here in particular was rather hard hit. I didn't realize it was quite that bad.
On Thursday, both houses of the legislature approved a $687 million drought relief plan that includes $15 million for Lompico and the other communities. The plan redirects money in the state budget and draws from two previously approved bonds. It will expedite $549 million in grants for infrastructure projects like capturing stormwater and distributing recycled water. It also includes nearly $25 million in food assistance and another $21 million in housing assistance for those impacted by the drought.
We're not waiving environmental laws. We're not hiking fees or taxes. We're using money we have available now to save time, to save water, and to help Californians hardest hit.
In San Benito County, farmers are cut off from federally supplied irrigation water, forcing many to let their fields go fallow. And with fewer acres of farmland, many field workers are going hungry and homeless with no work.
People who work the fields and who are their family, are the ones that suffer the most.
Sensing the urgency, Governor Brown last week asked lawmakers to quickly approve his plan to free up money that can be allocated immediately to drought-stricken communities. He also reminded Californians that everyone needs to do their part to save water.
This is serious. Today is a call for action.
Once the governor signs the legislation, water rights laws will not change. However, the State Water Resources Control Board would have new powers to issue fines for illegal diversions of water. Aaron.
All right, Mae, thank you. Lawmakers are negotiating changes to an $11 billion water bond scheduled to go before voters in November. Republicans are emphasizing dams and reservoirs to increase water storage, while Democrats want to make better use of existing water sources and restore watersheds.